Lewis, and I'm talking to Rob Jones of Visit Wales, and I'm at Slate Mine here in Wales. Rob, tell me a bit about this mine and your connection to slate mining.
Yep, you're in the National Slate Mine of Llanberis in North Wales, which was the largest slate mine in North Wales in its heyday. It was, as I mentioned, the largest and the most employed slate industry up here in North Wales. Industry in North Wales back in its heyday employed many thousands of people, many households within the area, all the families of which who lived there would be working in the slate mine in any way or form, and they would start as young children, as young as nine, and due to that, life expectancy for males especially wasn't that long. If you lived to 40, you were lucky. Because of the dust and the dark conditions that you used to work in for up to 12 hours a day, it was pretty tough going down there. And it didn't pay as well either. Pay was very, very, very poor. And due to large families, some about 12 kids in one family, you know, tried to feed them all. Was pretty difficult. My grandfather used to work in a slate mine down in Meirionnyddshire in southern Snowdonia, and sadly he died at the age of 65 due to the lung cancer of the slate industry, because he worked down the mine for about 30 odd years, and it was tough going. He'd have to get up about 5 in the morning, start work about 6, and then 12 to 14 hour day shift, and then back again. And in those days, you had to walk to the mine, and sometimes you could walk to up to about 3 to 6 miles a day just to go to your day job, and then just to work in darkness. And then you'd collect your pay at the end of the day on a Friday, and it wasn't a lot of money, and that would have to service the family for the full week again. So it was a very, very tough life, unfortunately.
And you were saying that families would live in these small, damp houses, yep, or small stone houses.
They would live in the cottages, yeah, which cottages were owned by the slate mine themselves. So when the miner would collect his pay on a Friday, his wife would have the money, and then she'd go and have to pay the rent for the cottage that they lived in, courtesy of the mining industry. So by the time they were working, basically, so they could give the money back for their accommodation, and that with that money they'd have to service them to buy their produce and everything like that. And in those days, you know, families were very large. You know, it's not like what you have today, up to about 3-4 kids. They were talking about 12-15 kids in one household, so it was pretty tough going, unfortunately.
And you were saying the children would share a bed,
yeah,
top to tail.
They would be about 6 to a bed, top to tail, you know, and especially the older kids. They would then off go off to work. Then the other youngsters would be able to go to bed then if they were working nights, etc. So it was like top to tail and in and out.
Because the children could start working in the mine,
yeah,
as door openers from 9 years,
yeah,
of age.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
So their schooling, if you had a lot of money, that's when you'd be able to go to college, etc. So, but as soon as you had your schooling and you wouldn't go to secondary school, you'd be down that mine straight away.
Yeah.
The reason being just to get money for the family.
Of course. And tell me in Welsh the name of the mound. Give me some Welsh here.
Okay. Dwi'n sefyll yn amgueddfa Llechi Cymru yn Llanberis, yng Ngogledd Cymru, un o'r chwareli mwyaf yng Ngogledd Cymru.
And you learned Welsh as a child. That's your first language.
Welsh is my first language,
yes,
and it was spoken at home and in school, and I was taught through the medium of Welsh.
Great. Thanks very much, Rob. That's
Croeso,
great.
Diolch yn fawr iawn.